Jacoby Shaddix. Papa Roach, what's up?
What's good?
What's good, buddy?
First question out of the box. You ever met Eddie Vedder?
Never met Eddie Vedder, man. Never met Eddie. That's one of the guys I think I probably like just would be tongue-tied, honestly. I met James Hetfield, and I just was like... yeah.
You did like, for whom?
Yeah, I'm all, my name's Jacoby. I sing for Papa Roach. He's all, I know you guys. I'm all, nice to meet you. Nice to meet you. I was just like...
Has anybody ever been like that around you? They get to meet Jacoby finally, and they vapor lock.
Yeah, it was yesterday. This young kid, he was hanging out the bus and outside on the street waiting for the bands or whatever. And I pop out, and he's just shaking. And my son is out on the road with me.
Yeah.
And he's kind of, I could see my son like kind of looking at the kid like, is he okay? You know, and I'm like, hey,
go speak
fine.
With him, son.
Yeah, he was totally cool. He's just a 16-year-old kid, just ready to
That's
rock
awesome.
And like, you know, just was like wanted to say that like our music had inspired us. He's playing, you know, playing music himself.
Hell yeah!
But he was just
the first thing I notice about you when you walk into the studio, you have a presence.
Oh yeah,
you're extremely confident.
Mm-hmm. Oh okay,
unless it's you know a show.
It's all a show.
Is I just, it?
When I leave, I go home and I'm looking in the mirror.
No,
I'm like,
bastard! Do you really have a high confidence?
I mean, I think it's one. I mean, I guess to a certain degree, but I think it's like for me, I guess one of my gifts. I could walk in a room and light it up. I don't know.
Being a front man of a band like Papa Roach, you can't be. A wet blanket. You can't go out there with the personality of wet lettuce. You have to have. It's to where a drummer has sticks, a guitarist has his piece. You have to have that confidence. That is quite literally one of the tools of your trade is that confidence.
I just love the phrase wet lettuce.
Wet lettuce.
So good, dude. I know, it's just like limp and just hanging there, a little drippy, a little brown.
You're
like,
crisp lettuce.
Yes, I'm crisp.
Fresh cabbage.
Well, yes.
We met you years and years and years ago at Merriweather Post Pavilion. You came out to the 932 Club. You did a meet and greet, and you're the same person you are now.
Awesome.
We did a Zoom with you. You're the same person you are now. You do have an energy about you. Jacoby Shaddix, Papa
I enjoy
Roach.
Life, man.
But what is, like, when are you off? Like, are you on right now? Or, like, when you're off, what's that look like?
Well, you know, when I'm, like, just low-key chilling, I'm when I'm home.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I'm just low-key dad. I'm like, taking the kids to school, you know, picking them
what's
up for
that
sports.
Like?
It's,
Do you get a lot of looks? Like, or does everyone
know?
Yeah,
I get some strange looks, especially when it's, like, the first day of school or first, you know, beginnings, people are like, who's this guy?
Yeah.
But you ever a parent like lean over and kind of go, I love Metamorphosis. And then I'll see you at the pancake lunch.
Of course.
I'll see you at the pancake. You know, it's funny, man. I've made some actually really good friends through, because I have like 21-year-old son, 18-year-old son, but then I have, we also have Brixton, who's 9.
Yeah.
And so now we're kind of in the phase of he's young. So now there's these new families we're meeting and we're like, we've already done this before.
Right. Yeah.
And, you know, it's like, all right, who are these new families we're going to meet? And we've actually met some pretty rad families, like some straight up rockers.
That's
and
awesome.
And I'm like, okay, cool. I found my people.
Yeah.
There you are.
Similar tribes. Yeah. And you can identify with the rigors of the road. As a guy, I'm living in suburbia.
Yeah.
I got a cool job, but I ain't got a Papa Roach job. I can't identify with having to take... Like a Brixton, on the road, tour bus, screaming fans. My son has never had to see a teenager vapor lock in front of him. So to find other people in those similar familial tribes that go, this is what it's like, a family on the road.
Oh, yeah.
It's got to be a place of comfort.
It is cool, man. It's good to meet people that understand, you know, that element of what I do. But then, you know, it's like when I'm home, too, it's like it's good to just kind of unplug from this whole world. It's honestly like a duality. It's like
when's the last time you had to use your dad voice? You had to get on that ass a little bit.
Probably about like 3 days ago.
Yeah.
You know, he just wasn't.
Give me the dad voice.
So, Brixton. Brixton, listen. Hey, Bubba, hello. Are you there? You know what I'm saying.
Get off my ass.
Yeah.
So, I'm playing Switch.
No, I got him. I was bold enough and brave enough to try to bring him on the road this time. I've always had my boys out on the road, but not during the school year. And this year we're homeschooling.
Okay.
And so that was, I think, might have bit off a little more than I could chew.
Yeah,
I've called my wife a couple times going,
And I'm guessing.
How do you do
so
Common Core math?
I was going to say he's nine, so I was just there. They're like, it's a little multiplication, a little long division going on.
Yep.
And it's been a minute, so I'm sitting there at home going, thank God I have my smartphone. I've looked up so many answers.
It's like math riddles.
I hate it.
Yeah, same here. I was looking at my guitar player across from him. I'm like, dude, I'm not an idiot, am I? He's like, this is so useless. I'm like, okay, cool. Don't worry about it.
You're backstage. You guys are about to like go into Getting Away with Murder, and you're hitting up the missus like, baby, what are the three branches of government? He's asking me. I got judicial,
I have no
legislative.
Idea.
There's a third one.
I have no idea.
That is so cool.
I want to ask you again about confidence. Not to bring the whole Tony Robbins thing vibe in here. But I think I'm so impressed with your confidence and aura because I'm completely opposite.
Right.
I have no confidence. The only time I have confidence is when I'm on the radio. So were you always confident even as a kid? Or did you have to learn that? I know you lead a band, but a lot of people who are in show business and lead a band or whatever, off the air, they're totally different.
Well, when I was young, when I was a kid and kind of getting into music or whatnot, I was a band geek. You know what I mean? I wasn't like the cool kid at school. And I got into sports, started doing that. You know, that built my confidence a little bit, but I wasn't that good. I'd always find myself on my back on the football field. I'm like, all right, maybe this isn't for me. And so it wasn't until I found music, honestly, and got on the mic that I found that confident space.
Right.
And it took me a while because I was younger. I got bullied a bit, and just kind of a nerd, a chubby kid, fat boy, get bullied a little bit, built my character
up.
Glow
up.
That's right. Now, I'm a Mississippi 7. Let's go.
Yeah.
Or maybe an 8.
You're Baltimore 12.
Hey, I'm a Balti 12.
Look at all those teeth.
I promise not to ask any more confidence questions.
Hey, dude.
Falling in Reverse.
Real nice.
How do you like their reimagination of Last Resort?
Absolutely love it, man.
It's pretty incredible.
It blew my mind. When we started Rockzilla Tour, probably about a year and a half ago, he pulled up. I had talked to him probably about a year before that, or even 6 months, I don't know. It's like, hey, man, we're looking for people to do like some reimaginations of our songs. And he had done it, and he's like, I'm so excited to play this for you. So he came to our dressing room, puts
so
it on the
speaker. So he had a fully ready-to-go copy, and he played it for you.
He played it for me. He's like, I'm so nervous. I'm like, I'm nervous, dude. I hope this is dope, dude.
Yeah.
And literally, he nailed it. He honestly, it like cut to the raw emotion of the song. You know what I mean? And I he killed it.
Here it is right here.
Just a little bit of this.
Whoa.
I tried to pause it.
Oh, goodness.
Hey, FCC, man.
Yeah.
I tried to pause it in time. I couldn't get my
damn this.
Hey, I can tell you goddamn FCC.
I think of, you have a comedian that'll do an impersonation of somebody.
Right.
Like, they'll mimic someone in front of that person, and you wait to see how they react.
Yeah, he makes me nervous.
That's got to be, like, heart-pounding. Like, Frank Caliendo's gone on record has been like, there's some people that love it and some people that looks like they want to wring my neck. Like, I think of another great cover, Disturbed, Sound of Silence.
That's a
legendary cover.
Absolutely.
And then you get some others that you go, I wonder how the original artist felt about that cover of Dancing in the Dark.
Oh, I got a funny story for you.
Okay.
So MTV back in the day asked us to come do this thing to honor Aerosmith. And what was the song? Sweet Emotion. They were like, we want you guys to do Sweet Emotion. And I'm just like, let's go.
Yeah.
But that's like big shoes to fill.
Oh, yeah. Dude, you don't want to mess that up.
We just hacked our way. It was bad. It was not good. Honestly, like.
Was that the Icon show? I think it was called MTV
yes.
Icon.
MTV
yes,
Icon.
Because
that.
They did a Metallica one where Limp Bizkit did a version of Sanitarium that I've heard two members of Metallica loved, and two members had to have a talk with someone.
Yeah.
And you can see Lars was like, this is great. And you could see Hatfield being like, get my manager right now. Did you have a chance to talk to them afterwards? Or?
It's funny because our drummer at the time ended up marrying Mia, one of Steven's daughters. And so that was like the beginning of a relationship that happened at this place, And I could tell that they were just kind of like, that was loud.
That was a composition of music.
Yeah. And it's like we were. we're young numbskulls, you know, playing like, yeah. I mean, new metal, you know, we weren't like classic rocker vibe, you know? And so we did our best, but it just wasn't good enough. It just wasn't good.
Jacoby Shaddix joining us on the program, Ramshead Live, last night.
And Papa Roach.
When you guys first broke in 93, you've gone through different iterations. You know, your Johnny Vodka, Dakota Gold.
Oh, yeah.
And we know kind of famously that Darius Rucker sort of took it on the chin with being Hootie of Hootie and the Blowfish.
Yeah.
How many times are you still referred to as Papa Mr. Roach, you're nasty?
Are you him?
And are
I'm
you
like,
who?
I'm all, depends on who him is. Huh. They're like, Papa Roach. I'm like, I mean, I guess.
I'm in the band.
I mean, I'm in the band. I sing for the band. They're like, oh, it's not like, oh, yeah, my name's Jacoby. What's up? You know?
Yeah.
And so, yes, I've been, I don't mind it so much now. I'm like, yeah, I'm going to cut my life into pieces guy. You know that guy?
That's the guy.
Yeah.
One of the first things you also noticed the minute you walked in here, as Josh pointed out, just confidence, the likes of which I wish I could put into a pill form and boof. B-O-O-F. Look that up. As you pointed out in the background, the leg.
The fake leg.
The fake leg. The prosthetic leg.
The prosthetic leg, man.
Scott, you care to introduce Jacoby to our old friend Paul Mittermeier and what happened to him?
Oh, Paul. Yeah, we had a sports guy named Paul Paul Mittermeier. No, he's still with us.
He's still alive.
He's still alive. A new gig.
Okay.
But he had a fake leg, and he lost it when he was, what, 21 years old?
Yeah.
He worked in a boatyard, and one of those big boat forklift things ran over his leg.
Just
and
pulverized it. Wasn't like a clean, like, Chinese factory slice. It was
it turned into mush.
Into meatloaf. He had to crawl 3 miles.
That's not true.
Okay. Sounds cooler though. Can we go? Can you go there, please?
He
was dragging his body.
He was dragging his way. But he had his leg. He lopped it off, and then he gave us the old one to play with because he got this new Starscream looking piece of hardware that's got like a Wi-Fi signal.
Yep.
It's got pneumatics. He has to charge his leg the way you got to charge your phone.
Yep.
It's beautiful.
It's funny that you, because I saw that and I was like, my son's girlfriend, her uncle. We call him Uncle Randy. He's actually younger than me.
What's up, Randy?
Uncle Randy's got prosthetic leg as well. Same deal. But it wasn't a boat forklift. He was out on those, you know, the side-by-sides.
Yep.
And just was ripping on a side-by-side, flipped this thing, and just...
Lost a leg?
Yes, lost his leg, God. Bro.
Wow. We've been on side-by-sides. We've been in a side-by-side with Travis Pastrana.
Oh, what?
Yeah, dude, he's a Maryland boy. He lives right on the street.
That's sick.
Travis, if you're listening, you got the warm line. Call. He checks in on all the time.
Yeah, we'll get Travis to call in.
He's dope.
He goes down to his house all the time, but he took us... he calls it a hell ride, on his property, and you go through the woods. He takes you on the hell ride and a side-by... Dude, it was one of the greatest things I've ever done.
It's incredible.
Did you have your Cottonelle wipes with you?
Brother.
I felt zero... I wasn't nervous at all because, like, you're sitting next to the best in the world.
You're right.
It's like...
True.
Yeah. It was almost like this euphoric moment where I just let myself enjoy it.
It was 90% awesome, 10% scary horny.
Yes.
Horny and terrified as he rockets through the woods. Speaking of, you know, Brixton, his daughter, she's sending people... at the age of 8 over like 100-foot jumps in a quad.
Oh, my.
Talk about the acorn that didn't fall far from the tree. It's still attached to it.
Yeah, for real. That's gnarly.
Jacoby, before we jump, we got to talk about the performance that we got a clip of from Cleveland. Because we're going to play the song coming up.
Well, you do this at every show, right? This 988, by the way, the Suicide Crisis Prevention Line. We promote it here on the program. They sponsor a bunch of our features on the program.
Awesome.
We're always... hammering home 988. We've all been touched by it. And Papa Roach, you guys are doing something very cool at every one of your shows now.
Yeah, so we're doing like it's a straight up PSA in the middle of the show. And I was kind of apprehensive. I was like, are sure we're gonna do like a PSA? Like, shouldn't I just speak it? And I was like, let's put it together and see what it's like. And we wanted to take an opportunity and just, because we're in the middle of a crisis right now.
Yeah.
I mean, it's like suicide is, it's worse than ever. And I think it's important that we just take an opportunity and speak to our people and let them know that there is help out there.
And is it true this came about after a college friend tried to take their life?
So years ago, the song Last Resort was about one of my best friend I was living with. It was my roommate. We were in high school together, and he had tried to take his life. We were living together in the house, and that was just like a traumatic experience. As you know, I was 17 years old at this time, and just to watch my friend go through that was as rugged, you know. And it's something you don't want to deal with, you know. And last resort itself is it's a cry for help, you know. And we've met people year after year. So many people have told us, "Yo, man, like your music saved my life." Mm. And you know, the first few times you hear it, you're like, "Wow, that's intense." Like, are they BSing me? But then when you hear it like time after time, we've been doing this for, you know, drop that track back in 2000. Like our music has really touched people in a meaningful way. And I think that that's like, I'm grateful for that.
That's, you know? That video that I got to see of the Cleveland performance where you got to see just a sea of lights.
So then you play the song Leave a Light On, and yes, then the whole crowd takes out their phones. They hold them up.
You could tell. Yeah. It's people are connected. They're feeling it.
And like you said, so it's a PSA. It's you in front of basically a white screen.
Yeah.
And it's you talking. And I think it was brilliant to do it that way because you said, why don't I just speak on the microphone? But I feel like if you were to just speak on the microphone, that can almost get caught up as part of the performance or something. But to have the juxtaposition of being at a rock show, mm-hmm, and then all of a sudden right in the middle, there's Jacoby on the screen in front of a white thing speaking to you. I think that's a brilliant move because it garners everyone's attention. You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
That will get their attention and get them to listen.
Yeah.
And that's brilliant because we've all been there, 988, whether it's you or someone you know.
It's Suicide Prevention Week. It started yesterday. It goes to the 16th. It should be suicide prevention around the year, and it will be, but this is an extra special focus this week. Let's take a quick break. We come back.
All right.
We'll come back with you, Jacoby from Papa Roach, and let's hit up Leave a Light On. Get more into that.
Right on.
We'll get the PSA posted, the whole deal. Coming up, more with Jacoby. Yeah, Mr. Jacoby Shaddix joining us in studio from Papa Roach.
Getting some great texts, Jacoby. People out there love you, love your band, and
love this cause.
All right. Like you were saying, man, to never, we get it too. I mean, I don't, you know, we're all kind of, you're in the music, we're in the radio, we've been doing this a while, and sometimes you get people that come up to you and they're like, hey, like your show, the three of us, have meant a lot to me and got me through some.
Absolutely, that's good stuff.
And it's
what's up, Jonathan Sawyer. Love
you,
buddy.
Yeah, and it does it makes you, sometimes you can forget.
Yeah.
Do you feel occasionally unworthy? I get that sensation personally.
Imposter syndrome. I'm not worthy. There's a lot of that.
When someone tells me, to Scott's point, to your point earlier, hey man, what you do saved my life. I like kind of lean in close, like really?
For real?
What? What was it about that fart sound I played that really?
Hey, that's
and if it's that's what it took, brother, yeah. I don't care.
Yep, it was the wetness of that.
It was
fart
the
sound.
Juiciness betwixt the cloven cheeks.
The cloven
cheeks. Cloven cheeks. Jacoby, would you do me the pleasure and the honor of my brothers and I here of introducing this next song?
Oh, snap. We're going into it, man. This is the first time I'll ever hear this song on the radio, too. This is awesome.
Kind of cool.
Tripping.
Let's get it.
Right on. This is P. Roach with, or Papa Roach with Leave a Light On.
Look at me. See what you did to me?
Here it goes. Scott's crying.
There's some mistiness.
Can I ask you?
Wow.
During the song,
God.
You were holding both sides of your headphones, and your eyes were closed, and you looked like you were somewhere else. Where were you?
I just, whenever I hear our music for the first time, like when it's being played on air, it's a special moment. For me, you know, I think
I got video of that. Can I share that? Or is
yeah,
that
sure.
Okay?
Yeah, absolutely.
It was very cool to watch you listen to your own song. And that's an incredible song.
Thank you. That one, it's like, I think for me as a father, that was like where I was coming from on this one. Like I just sent, you know, my two older boys away. They're going to college. They're off on their own now. And like, you know, I did my best, right? Like we'll see how they live their lives, you know?
Yep.
And it's like, that song is just a message to my boys. Like, no matter how far out there you get or what goes on in your life, like, I got your back. Like, I'm here for you no matter what. Even if you feel like you're not worthy of the love, like, I got you. You know, and that's an important message, I think, for people just in general right now.
Like, has Papa Roach had crossover success? I'm trying to think of all the singles you've had. Is it mostly
Scars?
Rock?
Scars was one that kind of went over.
I'm hearing this on multiple stations. That song's yes.
And if there's a song I want to cross over, it's a song with that message.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
That's a song I want. Again, one of the reasons we're talking about this.
Yeah.
It is Suicide Prevention Week.
Yeah.
988. We can't say it enough. 988.
Yeah. Please, people.
Don't make people a permanent decision in. Damn, to a temporary I'm crying. Problem. I'm glad you got to hear it with Jacoby. Yeah, that was a cool moment, man. That was very, thank
you for
that.
The pain doesn't go away if you do that. You just give it to others.
Yeah.
Jacoby, I love you. Thank you. There it is. That is the latest Leave a Light On from Papa Roach. We got Jacoby Shaddix in studio.
In true JSS fashion, after going from something so beautifully poignant and so moving, we're now going to get your shirt off at a spa in about an hour and rub you with soothing liniments. We don't transition well. Instead of going from some beautifully like deep, moving, poetic segment to something very similar, we're going to cover you in like persimmon and garlic.
Smothered and covered?
Basically.
Are you going to baste me like a turkey?
You're getting facials. You're
getting the Waffle
petties.
House treatment.
Yeah. Can I just ask about this song, which is like, I still feel it. It's so powerful. And how long did it take to write that? And how many times did you record it before you felt that you nailed it?
That one came out. Every song is different when we're in the studio writing, but that one was quick. It just flowed out. You know, it's like something that when we're in the process of creating music, it's, you never know what's going to happen in a room. Right. And sometimes there's magic in a room. And that day there was magic in the room. Wow. And that's like, for us, those are the moments that we latch onto. You know, that's like, it's because sometimes it's like, you know, we had a song called Lifeline and we just recorded and rewrote and redid that song 15, 25 times over, where by the end of it, I hated the song.
Yeah.
You know, and it's like this one just kind of flowed. And those moments, you got to seize them, you know, and for us, we want it stripped down, because that's sometimes when we're writing music, it's like, it's just an acoustic guitar, a piano, and a drum machine, and we're just kind of vibing in a room. And you know, we just kept it that way. We're like, this one needs to be stripped down, real, raw, organic, no trickery, you know, just...
And the vocal performance.
Yeah, and that one, I remember we recorded this during COVID, so we went and we got an Airbnb down in San Luis Obispo, and a lot of the vocals on this album, I'm just recording in a bedroom.
Wow.
On a mic, this SM7?
Yeah.
On this microphone.
Wow, that is wild.
Yeah, so it's like nothing real special. It's just a good song with a good performance and
you nailed
a meaning.
It.
You know, thank you very much. We've been playing it live, and it's, honestly, it's my favorite part of the set, because it's just so different from the normal Papa Roach, like, let's set it off. Let this get this place
popping.
Yeah,
the thing explodes, but it's one of those shows where they take you, Papa Roach, the band, on a journey where it can't just be at a 10 the entire time. Mm-hmm. Otherwise, that 10 is not going to matter. But if you bring them back down and then out of nowhere, head back up, hit cut the line off the new album, people will go nuts. That was a beautiful moment. I'm glad Scott
appreciate
got
it.
That. Thank you for letting us share that. Thank you.
Can I
ask
changing lives? It's amazing.
It's amazing.
Really.
And can I ask you another very strange question? It was today is 9/11.
Yeah.
What? Give us Jacoby Shaddix's. Where were you?
Oh, I know exactly where I was, man. I just got off tour. I was got home like 2 days before, and I was sitting in my living room of my home, and was. My wife comes running, she's like, turn on the TV. And I'm like, all right. And I turn on the TV and just see this horrific sight. And I was just like, what in the, this is not real life. Yeah. Yesterday I was tripping around.
You guys were still touring and fest.
Yeah. That was that time. And I was just like, what in the world just happened? And I had friends in New York. So I'm like reaching out to them going, what's going on? Reach out to my boy, Renee. I'm like, dude, y'all right? Like, and New Yorkers lived through a horrific moment in time. I was just down on the harbor here in Baltimore, and they got
the
piece
steel.
Of that piece. I saw that last night. I took my son on a little trip around before the show and saw that. I was like, oh, man, here we are at that day again. That was a bad one.
Yeah, never forget.
Brother, that was beautiful.
Yeah.
Everyone's checking in saying last night at Ramshead was absolutely off the chain.
It was a banger.
Dude, Ramshead does it right.
It was
and
a good
Papa
time.
Roach gets it done. And we're going to put a bow on this, let you stretch, get a cup of coffee, and then, well, I think we've kind of gotten into what we're doing with him today, but not a ton.
I mean, we're going to take him on a spa day.
Yeah, we're going to basically
take you out. Because we talked about your We did a Zoom with you, and then we got to talking about like
skincare regimens.
Skincare regimens,
and you actually ran and went and got soap and brought it back in.
Dr. Bronner's soap.
That's
that you
right.
You use.
That's it.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
That's it.
Oh yeah.
He had the peppermint Dr. Bronner's.
Just listen, make it all tingly and spicy.
Felt like your butthole smoked a menthol.
That's right.
Sometimes it gets a little too tingly in certain areas. You got to be careful. Dr. Bronner's.
My little guy Brixton has used it, and he's like, "What?" He's like, "Look, what was that?"
You okay, buddy?
I'm like, don't worry about it, son. You'll be fine. Just better get that soap washed off.
Yeah, it gets minty.
The burn lets you know it's working.
Okay? That's right.
Your balls have the freshest breath right now. Yeah. It is nuts, man. So we kind of latched onto that because we just remember how much you lit up talking about trying to keep that porcelain skin of yours smooth. Right. So we're sending you to a spa.
Well, the funny thing is Joe brought it up. I think they're closed on Mondays, but there's a spa. And then right next door to it is a tattoo shop. So I was like,
"Let's just go get
it. Just go get tattoos instead?"
I mean, dude, I'll go get yatted right now.
Me too.
Dude, you just want to get marked up?
Joe, see if we get that place opened up. It's a Monday. They're closed.
He has to get a temporary tattoo or he will burn in Jewish hell. So excuse him. Yeah. He can get a gentle drawing.
Hey, if we all go get tattoos with Jacoby, come on.
Look, I'll
attend.
I'll be honored just to watch.
I'm not trying to have you fry for eternity.
You can hold Jacoby's hand while he gets tatted.
Okay. Should we get a matching tattoo for our matching tattoos?
We'll see. The place is closed. If anyone knows anyone that owns that tattoo shop on Canton Square, tell them to open up. We're bringing Jacoby by.
Jacoby, we have testicle tattoos that match.
Are you for real?
We have two spaceships on our balls.
Sick.
Yeah. So maybe we
got... That's what's
you want to get a UFO on your balls?
How did you do that? Did you have to like stretch the bag out?
Screening.
Absolutely.
We did the bat wing and then had a very patient tattoo artist. Shout out Black Lotus.
We did a tour with a band called Hinder back in the day.
Hinder,
the guitar player named Blower. He had this thing. Yeah, dude, he would light his sack on fire nightly.
Yes, Ralph.
Yep.
And our dude Ralph used to light his balls on fire.
Dude, he had his ball bag was nicknamed Tarpy because he could stretch this thing out.
Dude, like, I remember that.
Yes.
Dude, we used to have Hinder.
Did you meet Tarpy?
Yes.
Oh, my
Hinder
gosh.
Hinder played right there.
Tarpy.
And I remember Tarpy. Oh, my head is cracking.
He stretched this bag out. My friend Kyle Malone tatted Tarpy across this dude's side. It was, oh, my word.
All right, so stay tuned to the YouTube page, maybe the television show. How will today go? Either we're getting sports massages or we're getting our nuts tatted.
Let's go.